Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Economics at a Glance. We are done with the basic concepts of economics in our previous videos, and today onwards we will start microeconomics. Okay, what is microeconomics? I have already told you, economics dealing with the individual unit, that is called microeconomics. Well, the first chapter of microeconomics, that is demand, which is very easiest chapter. So we will start. Okay, so let's get started. So first, demand. See, in our daily life we are telling like, okay, we want to have luxury life, a BMW car. So these are our demand we used to tell. But in economics the demand is somewhat different. What it is? See, demand is actually the effective desire. Okay, well, what is desire? What we want. But why it is effective desire? Why? See, if desire is combined with this five characters, if your desire is combined with this five characters, then only that desire can be effective desire, which we call in economics as demand. What are that five characters? See, desire for a commodity. First, we should have the desire to have that commodity. Second is ability to pay. We should have that much amount of budget so that we can able to pay for that. Okay. Third one, willingness to pay. It's not that we have the money but there is no willingness to pay for that. Then that is not demand. We have money and we are willing to pay for that commodity. Okay. Next, at a point of time and at a given price, within this week or within this month, or at a given price which is already fixed by the market price, not that we will bargain. Okay, so we will have desire for that commodity, we have ability to pay for that, and we are willing to pay for that also at current time and at current market price. That is what demand. Understood? Okay, so what are the determinants of demand? Determinants means what are the factors which cause changes or affects the demand? See, first one, let me rub all this, just a second. Okay, first one is demand. Sorry, demand is a function of these determinants. What are they? First one is price of commodity. Price of commodity. Well, what is price of commodity? The price which you are paying for that, yes or no? How it affects demand? See, suppose let's say chips, okay? An Uncle Chips, when it is 15 rupees, when a Uncle Chips, it is 15 rupees, you go for buying one chips or two packets of chips. But when the price decrease to 10 rupees, what will happen? You will prefer to buy more, yes or no? So that is what the price of the commodity affects demand inversely. Inversely means when price will increase, demand will decrease, and when price will decrease, demand will increase. Okay, so this is the way price affects demand, but this is the price of commodity which we are buying. Okay, remember, this is the price which we are buying, price of commodity. Next is money. Money means money income. Okay, how money income will affect the demand? Well, see, when your income will increase, now my income is, let's say, 20,000, whatever my demand will be, when my income will increase to 40,000 or 30,000, it's very obvious my demand will increase, yes or no? So that is, money has direct relation with demand. That means if money income increases, it will increase the demand. If money income decreases, it will decline the demand. Getting the relation? Okay. See, next is T. T means time preference. Time. Okay. How time will affect the demand? See, this is summer. Okay, in summer season we are in need of AC and cooler, yes or no? But think about the winter season. Do you think there is demand for AC and cooler in winter season? No. So time favorability. If time is favorable, our demand will be increased. If time is not favorable, demand will decrease. Yes or no? So, see, if time is favorable, your demand will increase. If time is not favorable, demand will decrease. Getting my point? Next is price of related commodities. See, price of related commodity. Well, what is related commodity? The commodity which you are using, similar kind of commodity. Let's say an example. Tea and coffee. Okay? So you are consuming tea, coffee is also similar kind of thing. So, price of related commodity. Okay? Let's say coffee price has been decreased. Okay? First assume the price. Now for the present time, the price of tea is 5 rupees and price of coffee is 6 rupees. Let's say. Okay. Suppose I'll tell that coffee price has been declined to 4 rupees. Coffee price is now 4 rupees. Okay. So what happened? See, previously we are consuming tea. Okay. And now we came to know that price of coffee has been declined. That means we will switch to coffee. Yes or no? We will switch to coffee means demand of coffee will increase. Demand of coffee will increase means demand of tea will decline. Okay? Getting my point? So, when price of the related commodities decreases, the demand decreases. And when the price of, because it has been decreased to 4 and the demand of commodity decreases. So, similarly, if price of related commodity increases, it will increase the demand of commodity. Why? See, if price will increase, we will not prefer coffee. So, our demand for tea will increase. Yes or no? See, so same thing. Last one is population. See, population is very simple. Last one, this is population. How population in a country where the population rate is more population is there, obviously more demand will be there. The country where population is less, demand will be less. So population directly affects demand. That means population increases, so demand will increase. Population decreases, that means demand will also decline. Okay, so these are the determinants of demand. Now we will study what is the law of demand. Okay, there is a law of demand which is very important. See, the law says that demand is inversely proportional to price. Well, we have already discussed about that. But the thing is, here the definition of this law is ceteris paribus. Okay? Ceteris paribus, when price changes, it will affect demand inversely. Okay? Ceteris paribus, what I have told? Ceteris paribus means keeping other things constant. We have several determinants I have just discussed. So, if I will tell price only change, other things like money, price of related commodity, time, population, they will be constant. They will be constant. Then if price will change, it will affect inversely to the demand curve. Okay? How? We will discuss in the schedule. Just a minute. So we have studied price decreases, demand will increase. How? See, the same example I have told you. Units, price and demand. Let's saw chips. Okay? When chips price is 15 rupees, your demand is to purchase only two. Okay, when its price got declined to 10 rupees, you will purchase more, yes or no? So your demand increased to 4. Again, when price declined to 8 rupees, you increase your demand to 5. If we will plot this schedule in graph, see. Suppose this is quantity demanded and this is price in y-axis. So first my price, I will mention 8, 10, 15 here, 2, 4 and 5, okay. So initially it was 15, 2 here, next 10, 4 here, then 8, 5 here. So if I am join this line, this is called our demand graph, okay. This is graphical explanation of graph. So graph of demand is downward sloping from left to right, okay. Downward sloping, it is very important. Demand graph is downward sloping from left to right, okay. So this is all about your demand, determinants of demand and what is law of demand. In my next video, I will discuss the change and the shift in demand, how demand changes, how demand shift, okay. So to know about that, stay with my channel. Don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.